We have come to pray for wind. One more wild adventure to begin. Well, the thing is, I'm writing music all the time, so I think the start of the idea of making the album was actually, let me see, where are we now? We are now, well, beginning of this year, usually it's sending around demos to the guys in the band. We had been out touring in Europe and in South America. We started talking about making the album, usually it's a long process because it's making demos, sending out demos to the other band members, and the other band members sending in their ideas and their demos. So that kind of process takes time, and usually we have the time, so it should take time, and picking songs. And the other thing is looking at it, since the Flower King's been around for a very long time and we've made many, many albums, it's always like you're trying to make something that feels a little bit new, but at the same time you need to sort of make sure it's actually the Flower King's, the style is preserved in a way. It sometimes comes in the way you're writing, but also of course the way the band members are playing or singing, and the production. But we wanted to do something a little bit different, so usually sending out demos, and then you decide where to record it and how to record it. And we settled on recording in Stockholm in a studio. Then we just, listen to the songs, and people say, "Oh, I like that bit. I like that song." It's a fairly sort of democratic process. For the Flower Kings, it's been like that for a long time. For this record, it all sort of came natural from the touring that we made last year, and that was kind of a surprise even to me, because we were asked to come to South America after a very long time. We haven't been there for a long time, and then this tour came up in Europe that we did together with Spock's Beard, so we were sort of up and running. And for the tours, we had sort of assembled a new group of musicians. So we had the old guys in the band, me and Jonas Reingold and Hasse Fröberg, and two new guys, Zach Kamins, who is an American guy, slightly younger, or very much younger, I would say. And Mirko De Maio is an Italian drummer. Mirko I didn't know, and Zach, I actually produced an album for Zach some 10 years ago, I think, when he was a very young kid coming up and like a big Flower Kings fan. So he wanted me to produce an album, so I did that. So we knew each other, and he contacted me saying, "I saw that you're probably going on tour, and I just want to say that if you need an extra keyboard player, you know." So I said, "Send me some stuff," and he sent stuff. And really impressed. Yeah. So we went with the same band that was touring Europe and South America. It felt very natural because everything worked out really good, and these guys are really talented. They are super nice to be around and funny. We can laugh. If you can laugh together, I think it's a good band. For the new album, it's probably like every time you're trying to stay within the style or the styles that you've been, that made the band famous or whatever. and that we know that we play well, but at the same time you try to try something new. And something new doesn't necessarily mean something new or super fresh or modern. It could be something that, you know, you go back to rediscover something, some band that you used to love when you were 13 or something like that. But so in my case, I don't know if I can call myself a prog fan. From the beginning, I used to listen to Jimi Hendrix and Cream and bands like that, you know. So more coming in from like a blues rock thing. The Allman Brothers was another band that I really liked. And but then opening up to lots of pop music and lots of more like symphonic rock or progressive rock later on. So for me, it's been more like coming back to rediscover some of the bands that I liked when I was a teenager, when I was back in school. And for this new album, I at least try to remember what I liked about these bands and how they arranged their songs or how they wrote their songs, and not to fall into the typical whatever Pink Floyd, Yes, or Genesis. I mean, all the big main bands of progressive rock. It's very easy to fall into that and do like our version of it. But I try to, you know, you can set up rules when you make an album. You can set up rules and you try to sort of push it in a certain direction. I think we did with this album. So it's what I'm hearing or what I'm thinking about the album is that it's more diverse. It's more different styles, and some of it I wouldn't even call rock. I don't know what kind of music it is. It's just like music made on electric guitars and drums and lots of different keyboards and sounds and orchestral sounds and stuff like that. So I suppose it's progressing.